Hey everybody, it's Jang here from JANGBRiCKS.com with a look at another LEGO Ultra Agent set from summer 2014. This is the Tremor Track Infiltration set. Comes with 241 pieces. So the general idea with this Tremor Track is that it is a tank with metal battering rams with ends that look like hands. And you're supposed to be able, it's nice and low and it's supposed to be super heavy. So this thing would be slowly crawling up and just doing massive destruction in its wake, because those hands are going to be shifting forward and backwards like a boxer. Well, I don't think boxers box like that, but the idea is that, it's striking things in front of it, and you can do that however quickly or however slowly you want, and you can really put some force into it, so you can actually set things up in front of it and really hit them down and maybe even break some somewhat flimsy assemblies apart. So play-wise, that's pretty cool. But when you look at this thing from the top though, where normal humans would be seeing it, not from the super low angle that looks extra good on camera, to me that just looks very unfinished. All those Technic holes on those lift arms, it's just so very, very basic and simple. I wish they had put some stuff on top of those to cover those up, because that really takes away from the look for me. Kind of almost kills it a little bit. I like the hull, I like the base here. The use of dark tan is very good, has that very military kind of feel to it. Does have a large number of stickers for the size of the set and the number of parts in it. But I think they look very good on these slopes. Ones at the ends here, got a little bit of diamond plating kind of look in there, and then you've got some circuitry on these. Just they extend it out, put some slopes with the grill pattern in them, some of these along here, I just really feel like it could have been done better. Back here, you've got your control station, so this is where Tremor, the bad guy himself, will be standing, and he can control the thing supposedly by pushing on either side of the steering wheel here. It's nice that they used this style of wheel, not one that you see used very frequently, especially not nowadays, but it's different, I appreciate that. You've got flickfire missiles on the sides, so once again, more flickfire missiles. You can shoot these and angle them, and then these are just intended to be spares. So shoot this one off, put this in there, and you can shoot a total of 4 missiles before you have to go out in the field and reclaim the ones that are out there. I think this is supposed to be the big exhaust, probably would have a bunch of smoke coming out of it. A pretty cool looking thing overall, except for that look there, which again, just really is not good to me. The hands, I think, are done pretty well. Funny to have a modern vehicle with hands like that, but for what they are, for what they're supposed to be, all solid steel, just battering ram ends, I think they look pretty good. This is the target. This is what's supposed to be being attacked. It's a data store. They call it different things, mainframe, database. It's a major chip that has a whole lot of information on it. It's basically just a storage chip, like a giant SD card that's supposed to have all of the plans, all of the techniques and ideas and plans for securing Astro City and everything, all on that one single chip that's in there. This has a nice little bit of action to it, because you can kind of break this thing apart. The idea is if you hit it from the front, unfortunately the Tremor Track is, its hands are up too high, so it's gonna hit the thing up here. But if you hit it from lower, then you can knock this back, and out the back will come the Ultra Chip. That's a printed piece there, little 1x1 green transparent tile with a print on the top. They actually include 2 of these in the set, so one is a spare. It's an elegant little mechanism, but just a very small little thing. I think it looks really good, but it's just small. It would have been nicer if the Tremor tank could have actually hit the target that would cause this to spill out. As it is right now, you just have to kind of knock the whole thing down and then salvage the chip. So here are the minifigs, Tremor, and then Jack, not Nick, Fury from the Ultra Agents. Tremor has a really cool headgear piece that goes way down in the front. Just looks like he's got riveted steel all over him, and he's got those iron hands, which his tank kind of mimic. It's really supposed to be based on his own design. We'll look at what he looks like under the armor as well, but notice this is a bright silver, all this top bit. This is your normal metallic silver here for the hands. This is a much brighter look. I think it's actually coated on the outside. And then Jack Fury gets a stud shooter, which will actually shoot out that little 1x1 round plate. And he also gets a shield, so he can shield himself probably from the flick fire missile attacks, definitely not from the major iron hand battering ram attacks. And that's what he looks like from the back. And now you can see the torso detail on the back of Tremor. You can see he's really human under all that. He's just augmented. And now you can see the front of his torso clearly. A very cool print right there. Gosh, I wish that they had not covered that up or had used that torso for a henchman or something. Just like that, because that's really, really awesome. Would go great with all sorts of different sci-fi stuff, from Superman to, you know, kind of a Lego Transformers kind of thing, or maybe, you know, don't make it Transformers, make it GoBots or something. No, not GoBots. Star Wars, so many themes that could go with. And lastly, there's what Tremor actually looks like in his tank. So you see just how he stands back there. He's able to reach the ends of the little control wheel. And there's just a kind of a look at his scale relative to it. So to sum things up, I personally like Tremor, the figure. I like the base of his tank. I like the idea of the punching, but I just don't like the execution of the thing, the way it looks from the top. Personally, if I were to customize this to make it the way I wanted it, I would probably just keep the base as it is and just rework this stuff up on the top. In non-customized form, this really does kind of let me down. Just the look of it from the top looks, it just doesn't look nearly as good to me as it does on the box. I think it was a little bit kind of questionable looking on the box with just how obvious the hands are. It looks kind of exceptionally gimmicky to me. And in person, it's really no better, maybe even a little bit worse. For younger kids though, the play feature is definitely very cool. So I can't take that away from it. Feel free to share your thoughts about this one. I would love to hear what other people think about the set on the whole and how you think it compares to the other sets in this series. Please feel free to hit thumbs down on the video if you didn't like it, or thumbs up if you did. I appreciate it either way. I appreciate your feedback, and you know what's gonna happen now. I'm gonna go build some more stuff and bring you some more videos, so stay tuned. I'll be talking to you again very soon.